Okay, Indrajit, how are you doing today?
Yes, I'm doing well.
Sorry?
I'm doing well, and
You're doing good?
actually, yes. Actually, my elder brother had come, so I met him and just take off him.
Okay, so what does your elder brother do?
My elder brother does a government job and stays another city of this state.
Okay, which city does he live in?
Oh, he lives in Dum Dum.
Sorry?
He lives in Dum Dum.
Is that a city?
The city means town.
Okay. All right. So how was yesterday's session? We kind of disconnected the call, you know, we just
Yes,
got out of it.
exactly. Oh,
But
so
I think it was done. So how did you feel about it? Let's just quickly give it 30 seconds.
that was great, and I learned a lot of things that I have to know and have to correct my mistakes.
Good. Very good. I'm happy that you gained something out of it. All right, so today I'm going to give you quite a bizarre situation. You have to brainstorm a bit and tell me how would you react in such a situation. Are you ready for it?
And ma'am, bizarre means
Bizarre means something really out of the blue, something really unexpected and not good. Okay?
okay, let's
So
see.
bizarre is used, it's kind of a negative word, but
Okay.
quite shocking. Something that, you know, in a situation you
Okay.
don't know what to do. That's what you call bizarre. All
Oh. Oh.
right? Something really weird
Okay.
and unexpected and out of the blue when something, you know, hits you up.
Oh.
Okay? So
Let's
I'm
see.
going to give you the situation in which you are sleeping in your house. And suddenly cops come, you know, police comes to you at your doorstep, and you
Oh,
don't, and they
police.
arrest you without even telling you anything. So they just arrest you. They don't tell you what are you being charged for, what are you being arrested for. They just come and they just charge you without telling you anything. And you don't know what to do. You don't
Yes,
know, you know, what has happened all of a
it is
sudden.
really shocking to
It
me.
is quite bizarre, as I said, and it is shocking. But I'm going to give you this situation because I know already that you can brainstorm about it and you can give me a good solution and give me a good answer. So let's start there. Think about it for, 30 seconds to 1 minute. You have the time. But I want something really innovative and something, you know, creative. And as I said yesterday, don't make English a big issue. Think about the thing that you actually want to say
Okay.
and try to put words together. No matter if we are not even talking like for a long time, we should make sense and we should learn more. Okay? So gather your thoughts. I'm giving you time to think. Think about it and just tell me. How would you react? What would you do?
Actually, it is really shocking to me that why police are coming to my house, and why I didn't do anything. I didn't do anything. I'm just a student and I'm pursuing my BTech degree. So I'm just like shocked, and I can the vertigo may come, and I can't believe myself that it is a real. And so they are, if the police if the police are questioning about me and arrest me, then I definitely ask for why the reason. So, and if any warrant he has against me, then I definitely see this. And first of all, then I call my uncle. So what is going on? What the situation is going on? And why the police came to arrest me, and I didn't do anything. So I just convey to the police that I didn't do anything. I am just a student. I am really a common man.
Okay, as you said, you're a simple man, you're a simple boy who is, you know, pursuing his engineering degree, and, you know, something of this sort has just happened and you don't know how to react to it, and you're trying to recall things that, oh my God, where did I, you know, go wrong and what, you know, what did I do? Because you can't really think of anything.
Yes.
So you said you would call one of your uncles.
Yes, uncle, and to take this situation, because I'm not aware of this situation. It is really...
Why would you call your uncle? Is he in police?
Yes, yes. My uncle, my elder uncle is a police custom officer.
Okay, okay, good. So, okay. And let's say if you are, you know, you are supposed, let's say you are doing an internship. Or let's say, you know, the next day you have to go to college and it's like really, there's an important exam.
Okay.
How would you, you know, how would you convey your teachers or maybe the people present in the college that I can't come? How would you explain your absence? Because you of course can't say that, you know, I am getting arrested for no reason. So how would you do that? Think about it.
Then I have to call the HOD, sir, and I really confirm that why actually I didn't know. I tell him that the police came and arrested me, so I didn't do anything, and I'm really unaware of this thing. So let's see, but that's why I can't attend this exam. So please forgive me for this reason, for uncertain and shocking reason that I really don't know the reason why the police came and arrested me. So please give me some time, some days to manage it. Then I definitely go to the college and I will do the exam.
Okay.
If possible.
Okay. Okay. But so you would just straight up, you know, simply tell them the whole situation. You would not lie about it?
No, I don't lie, because it is really shocking and it is really unreal to me. So I didn't tell the HOD I do not lie, because it is, I do not do any.
But then don't you think it will kind of, you know, malign your image in the college? Because, you know, you have to go to college eventually, you know, after, let's say, if not today, if not tomorrow, you will be going there after a week. And it's a big thing. You know, if somebody, you know, gets to know, and it's not really, you know, because you're just being yourself, you're just telling everybody the truth. So how would you handle such a situation? Because you haven't really done anything and you have to tell people that, you know, some, you know, all of a sudden there's a policeman, you know, this inspector coming to my house and just arresting me for no reason at all. How would you explain that? I mean, is this practical? Do you think so?
Actually, I want justice.
Think about it. Okay, Indrajit, I think you're not taking your time. Take 30 seconds. Take a deep breath, think about it, and then give me an answer. Don't be confused. Don't be in a rush. There's no hurry at all. Take your time, okay? We want to learn. We don't want to rush into things and, you know, make nothing out of it. We want to understand and learn the language. So, and also brainstorm, so that you're able to gather your thoughts, so that you're able to understand what to say. Not just say. Not just to, you know, speak about if I have been given a topic. Brainstorm a bit and just think about it. Take your time. Don't worry.
Ma'am, I think that it may bother me later, but I definitely want the justice rather than peace, because the justice, when the justice will come, the they automatically
you mean the, when the when everybody gets the you know gets to know that you are not you have
real the truth the real truth yes and then obviously they automatically give the respect to me as they did earlier. So I just want the justice, what the real truth behind this whole story. So that's why
so you will not lie.
No, I in case that if I did any wrong thing or if I did any crime, then I definitely cover with anything to set my image. But it is I didn't do anything. So that's why I tell the truth.
Okay.
I tell the real event, what is going on.
Okay, let's say if the person says, like if the policeman says, you know, they take you to the station, they say that, you know, where were you last night? They are not telling you what crime you have committed, but they just ask you simply, where were you last night? So where were you last night? How would you prove your innocence? Let's say your mobile network matches the criminal at the spot. How would you prove your innocence? God. I know it's quite bizarre, but think about it. That's the question. How would you prove your innocence there?
I shall tell the police that I was there in my house all the previous day long, and if my mobile phone's network may match to the criminal, but I can't do anything because it is not up to me, it is not in my hand. So
but mobile phone would be in your hand, right? Okay.
Let me ask you one more question. I think you're really
getting confused in this. So the person says, you know, the policeman says that, okay, your location matches, you know, the crime location, and the mobile network, you know, it matches the crime location, and it is a fact, it is the truth. So they have already proved it, okay? They have gotten the records from the mobile company. So tell me, would you bribe the police? Would you bribe them? That, okay, take some money and just let me go. Would you do that to avoid the whole situation?
First of all, I do not bribe them at all because I do not do anything. I know nothing. So why I give some money for their concern? So I didn't do anything, and I'm really innocent. So I do not do nothing about that. So why I spend my money on that?
Okay, so you wouldn't bribe them?
No, not at all.
Okay, let me give you another shock. So let's say the police says, okay, so you're not giving them any kind of bribe, you're not bribing them.
No.
You're not really, you're just there to prove your innocence, and they're taking a lot of time and it's getting you,
yes,
you know,
obviously,
you are
obviously
right on the edge of exploding. Okay, so tell me, the police comes to you and later says that, oh, sorry, we arrested the wrong man.
What?
They arrested the wrong man. You were also at the crime location, but somebody else did it and they got to know it later.
Oh, they understand.
Okay. How would you react to it? What would be your reaction? What would you feel like? Yesterday we spoke about this thing that, you know, when I'm putting you in such a situation, then you feel the situation and react to it accordingly. How would you react to that? Think about it.
I just tell him that what are you saying that? Because you came here to arrest me, but now you are saying that it was a wrong thing to me. So I can't understand whole the thing. So I just I'm just paused for a while, and then what should I do? I asked to the police that what should I do, because I canceled my exam, the tomorrow's exam. I convey the HOD. So how do handle that? So please give me some suggestion to handle this whole situation, because to bring the situation back as a fine, it was fine earlier. So that's why I tell that to the police.
Okay. So you would just, tell them all this thing, but they, of course it's a natural reaction, but you would not be, concerned about, would you not complain the higher authorities in that case that, the police came to my house and somebody, just all of a sudden arrested me without any reason, and I've missed my exam and a lot more things, and, my respect is at stake. So would you just say it to them, or would you, do something about it? Because it is quite a big thing.
Yes, obviously. And I feel it, that it is really a big thing, and it is really...
unfortunate?
Unfortunate thing. But if it comes again, it happens again, then I definitely go for the higher authority. But for the first time, I let him go, because... man makes mistakes, so something, it is a not a mistake, it is a really big mistake, but
you're not responsible for other people's mistake, right?
Yes, I am not responsible.
You are not responsible for the mistake that police has done, right? The police has made. So it's not your fault. You are not at fault. You are just at loss here. Still, you wouldn't do anything about it?
I do not do anything against the police, because actually they helps a lot. So that's why. And for the first thing, if I take step against them, then for any short faults, or
you mean there was a small thing for you?
Yes. If I have some trouble, then they may avoid this, but don't they may not care this, because I goes against them.
Okay. So that's why
I first time I release it.
You would not do anything about it. Okay. So, okay, I think I've given you enough, given you enough difficult questions for today. It was quite a tough situation. Yeah. Okay. Let's talk about the language now. I think, first of all, I think you're a really, really sweet person, that you're not doing anything about anything. You're just letting people go. You're just sitting there and just being sweet with people, even if they were not really nice with you. I think that's really sweet of you. You are really a sweet person. I don't think there are many people like that, honestly. Okay, so let's come to the feedback, the language error that you've made today. So you said, while talking, you said, previous day long, I was at home. I didn't do anything, when police came to charge you. So it would not be previous day long. It would be all day long. Or maybe the whole day yesterday. Or maybe the whole time yesterday. Okay? But not previous day long. It doesn't fit. Okay? So what would it be?
the whole day long othoba
the whole time the whole time yesterday
oh the whole time yesterday
or maybe all day yesterday. Long
okay all day long all day long
but not previous yeah. day long okay
okay
okay so you I think you also have this thing in which you said I goes it's not I goes it's I go. Okay you also said they police people they helps us it's they is when you use they it's always
it's
help
plural
yes, like yes, a lot of help. People when you talk about okay so they means a group of people and they when you're talking about a group of people like more than one person it's always you don't really add an s or es so it's okay. they help okay okay one more thing you said I don't do anything they came arrest me okay that's wrong you should have said I didn't do anything because that was in the past that they arrested you okay oh. So I didn't do anything. They're still arrested.
I didn't do anything. Okay.
Okay.
I didn't do anything.
Yeah. You also said I don't bribe police people. So if you say if I don't do something, it means you do that on a daily basis or you do not do that on a daily basis. Okay. Oh. When you are putting it in simple present tense, so it means that something that happens on a daily basis. Like oh. I wake up in the morning. So that's something okay. that I do on a daily basis. Okay.
So ma'am, what should I
you should have said that? I would not bribe them.
Oh, okay.
I would not do that because that's like I'm asking you your intention. If you are ready to bribe them, then you would say, I don't think I would bribe them. Yeah, okay. or maybe you know, I wouldn't bribe them. So that makes sense.
I wouldn't bribe them.
I wouldn't bribe them. Would.
I would not.
Would. Would.
Would.
Would.
Would. Would. I would. Would.
Like will. Will. Would. Will. Oh. Would.
Will. Would. I would.
So it's W. Okay. Would. I wouldn't do that. Like it's a situation that you're thinking about it and you're thinking... No, I wouldn't do that. So it okay. makes sense that, you know, you have been put in a situation and you just, I asked you a question and you're just thinking about it and you were saying, I wouldn't do that. Okay. So it won't be, I don't do that. If I'm asking you, do you do that? So it means, do you do that on a daily basis or do you do that quite frequently? So you're saying, no, I don't do that. But when I'm putting you in a situation okay. For once, then you would say, I wouldn't do that. Okay. You said you paused okay. a bit. You said when the police came, you paused a bit. I think you meant you got numb. You got numb,
numb,
right? So just replace pause with numb. It means that you were quite shocked and you were numb and you didn't know what to do. Okay.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yes, obviously.
Okay. Yes. Also, one more thing, you said trouble. This is pronunciation error. It's not trouble, it's trouble. Repeat after trouble. Me. Trouble.
Trouble. Trouble.
Okay. Trouble. Say that again.
Trouble. Trouble.
Trouble. Trouble. Good.
Trouble.
It's not trouble, okay?
Oh,
you
trouble.
Clearly said trouble. It's a big trouble. No, not trouble. There's no word as trouble.
Okay. Trouble. Trouble. Okay.
Trouble. So I think these are the mistakes that you made while speaking. But you are up. I think one more thing that you need to add to, you know, while speaking is be clear with your words. So don't eat words. I said this yesterday as well while talking, because you know, when you eat words, you don't sound confident, even if you're saying the right thing. So just be clear in your speech. Say it out loud and clear. All right. So even if you're saying wrong English in front of me, because I'm here to help you, just say it out loud so that I can, you know, help you correct clearly.
Okay.
And I can hear you clearly so that I can correct you clearly. Okay. That okay. is going to be of good help to you.
Okay.
How was today's session?
It was amazing because you put me a terrible situation so to tackle this. So it is quite
you, awesome. Well, you put me in a terrible situation. When you say terrible, it means so bad. So just say it like that. Like it was, you put me in such terrible situations, Namrata, that I had to, you know, brainstorm and think about it long and hard. Say it like that. So that you sound confident and you're clear in your speech. Okay? Say that to me one more time so that the call is about to auto-cut.
You put me in such a terrible situation that I can explain myself properly.
Very good. You're going very good, okay? So keep learning and I'll see you the next time.
Okay.